Scoobascope is sponsored by
day of February. Ah, this weekend. I think this weekend for me had just, it was just like too much bad news. The coronavirus is still going strong, if I should say. Strong. That's also there. And then we have the locusts that finally made their way to my country. I'm looking at how that's going to affect us. Kagamba, is it a weekend? Njimaze nkola bi research, research, ebinga sa. I'm just saying though. Anywho, my name is Tina Fierce One. It's a brand new week. Let's get into it. What happened over the weekend in the world of celebrity? Let's get it. As much as Josephine doesn't want to associate herself with this here, I'm going to still say it. So me and Josephine are sitting down and we're thinking of like cool stuff that would shock the world. I mean, the coronavirus has shocked us. The locusts are shocking us. So we're thinking of kiki kisobola okusa tizensi yonna netubeera ku bunkenke. Of course, everyone would go for obvious, you know, president or a country or bomb one country, start a world war, or world war two, or world war three, who cares? Our approach, though, is different. We were thinking, what if someone kidnapped the Pope? Not kill him. Kidnap the Pope. Do you know the secrets of the Vatican? I believe with just kidnapping the Pope, we can get so many answers in this world for all the questions. Just think about it. Do you know what Zeko? It's the Vatican. When you take the Pope, you have taken the Vatican. Do you know the secrets of the Vatican? And of course, about Wali Demuna Fevenava Katulichi. So you've taken an oh, please. You know what? My head is random. Anyway, it's the 10th day of February. My name is Tina Fierce One. The show is proudly sponsored by Fanta. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Ha! Yo, guys. Mulimu some entertainers who I don't have to really talk about. Because, well, tebanga so chinene chidiyao. Maybe we have ono nyenyo. Ngatebi sanyu de guang kanange nembio gerako. So, Matthias walukaga, Matthias. Bamu itabati. In English, it would be Matthias. Matthias. In Uganda, Masias. Masias. In something that is almost like English, but in Uganda, you know what, Joseph, and I can't even deal. Anyway, there's this clip of Walukaga. First of all, agenda kwe simbao. Agenda kwe simbao, Walukaga. Agenda kwe simbao, nze nali manya saga. Na yali siriasi. Ebiyo kwe simba kacha abiriko. Nema na, not that education should be a key in your rulers, the people who are going to help you govern you. Matias, ya kuma mpitu. Anyway, that's besides the point. So there's this clip of him. He sits down with a different television and they're giving him like, it was kind of like an interview. And then the chick interviewing him just decides to just hit him with a curveball. She goes like, Batugamba steady house, Josima, he lost his cool. She's like, Batugamba walia no kulia, he walked out of the room. And it was so funny. For me, of course, he's had so much drama happening in his life this weekend. Waloje agenzenga, I know kuyimba, nebamuga no yimba. Like, his name has been buzzing this weekend. But what made me laugh about this is the same thing I have been saying. Remember when Bobby Wine's whole people power thing started? When it started, everybody ngabo yo get up people power in any light, any way, they would jump up on you, nebakuvuma, nembagamba, people are going to have to choose. Now, a chima consensus about this whole situation is that for popularity, they all first ran to Bobby Wine, people power, because they knew he had the numbers. Now, for survival, they are running to my president. I mean, it's so funny that all of you people couldn't see this. Like, you're supporting all these different artists, celebrities. Hey, tuliba people power. Hey, tuliba NRM. Hey, you forget that they are in support of two things. Popularity and finances. Whichever one of those two comes good for them is what they go for. Case in point, when Ronald Mayinja did that song and sang it with the president in the same room, all of you carried him up. Mathias walukagono genyini gwenjo gerako. Nyina ka clip yali aze wano. Kubukede, ngenda kabaza nyira. Yeje wano, nagamba. What's his name? Ronald Mayinja. Oye msaja tasobola kulia, si muntu wanguzi, tasobola kulia. Dede, ya muwakanira, na muwakanira netugamba. Ah, indeed, Mayinja tasobola kulia. Wetuogere obudde wano. Motoka ya Mayinja jali na temujimanyi. We know the entire number of cars that were brought in to be given as... Tuzimanyi, Kenzo ya kafunako, Mayinja ya funako, Bebekulu ya funako, Big Eye tetumanyi na esichi woyo ya fune motoka. Big Eye tasobola ya fune motoka na rajitulaga. Nenga abazi funye jebali, ata we know the make and model of all these cards. Anywho, yagamba Ronald cannot eat, but even new people need to see it. Ronald Mayinja first came with people power chants because he wanted the popularity. When he got the masses and the numbers, he sat down and he's like, yeah, yeah, Fabali Muchintu. But then he understood that the popularity will not fit him. Because if you are Team Bobby Wine, well, omanye tibibiteno bagwako, you are not going to sing, you are not going to have concerts. Enjale jakuluma. Not that these men actually enjale solo baluma, because people like Ronald Mayinja, I'm told, own like half of Kampala. Muzi Akedi, Muzi Bichi, they own so much. Can I just take a moment, even if I've not completed that statement? Because Mumanye began to kudako. I want to take a moment and just thank myself. Yeah. That I actually knew all of this was going to happen, and all you guys were like, nah, Tina, nah. Well, Babo, can they hear you?
Gama, you see, baby, I'm a Yinja Bini Baga and Magara, who seven about Saint A. Moriwani Yemi.
No, is an Emma Yinja. Whatever to sound, you don't have to be patriotic. We've been spreading that peaceful gospel even before my Yinja meeting with President Museveni in Serena. Are we together?
Hey.
Kwanga, whatever you know, you know, we got to the moon to move.
Wait,
that actually changes the entire ball game. I thought I was going to get off this, but it changes a lot. So what if Balaam and Catherine and all of those people think that they're actually playing a game of winning over numbers, and yet in actual sense they are willingly coming so that they can take, they can partake and then fund their different agendas come 2021. Like, say if I want to be an MP in 2021, I will go to my president because he is in the mood to keep giving. It's the strategy he has. So I would go to my president. Nendiayo chendi deo nechimotoka neva chimpa. Nembiteka kusaidi. 2021 wejanga mugamba blood. I thought I understood our relationship, but I'm not. I am going independent, or I am joining a different party, or I am doing my own party using your own money. That is genius. Jesus. Josephine, do you think we just gave them a magazi? I feel like I just killed my entire plot with my mind, because if opposition hasn't been looking at it like that, they can actually now look at it like that. Muweleze ya bantu wa mwe, ba collectinge, kubali ziga ba. 2021 mubalumi yomu tuwe. Or, I could have helped my president understand that they're actually playing him. So he should also stop giving them the money and just decide for if you want to pledge your allegiance, pledge it without any money involved. Oh my goodness, I just solved this country's political quagmire. Don't laugh, Josephine, I'm smart. Okay. Salvador has an upcoming event. That's on 14th Africa. He's going to be celebrating 10 years doing comedy. Good thing for him. Happy for him. So over the weekend, again, he visited Kasuku's show. Most of you who have watched TV know that so-called show. And he had to address the whole situation of him meeting the president and what the backlash was. And for the first time, I was so proud. I felt, woo! He said, Tebi nkwatako, oba musanyuse, oba temusanyuse. Let us learn how to respect each other, first of all. And then let us learn how to live in harmony. I'm entitled to what I want. You're entitled to yours. Let's just live in harmony. In my mind, I was like, but I've been preaching this for the past, 2 years now? So now is when you people notice. Because there's a time when Salvador was so heavy. He was so heavy on the Twitter streets and the Facebook streets about Bobby Wine and people power and the ideology. But now, I think maybe his mindset changed. I wish we had presidential debates this year. And they just let me draft up the questions for the candidates. We're going to be taking personal jabs, because, anyway, he says he doesn't care, he's entitled to his opinion. Why I keep running these political stories is because, one, there was a huge divide among Ugandans simply because of everyone having their own ideology that they believed in. So it created hate. Animosity, Facebook was hard to live with. But I'm glad we are embracing the fact that abagala okulya jebali na abagala okubagulira emmere jebali. Binyuma. 2020 is going to be lit. Hey, not 2021. This 2020. Waguna gwerako. Josephine, tugenda wa president. Someone told me, the last we checked, Chameleon was DP, innit? Mm-hmm. No, he was first People Power. Then he was DP. Then there was another Chivulu and he was People Power again. After declaring his DP. And now he's DP. But then again, someone told me he might have got one of the cars that we have been talking about. As if I'm steady. So, I guess he's living up to his name. I think it's NRM now, on the law. On the law. We need to find out, but I mean, it's Chameleon. The man chose his name ever so wisely. Like I've said, abali amulie, techina buzibu, wabaziba, wabaziba, wademulie. Atena mwe mulekera okunyi gambu, balide. Bwabera gwe. Bwabera gwe. Ene bebe, bude ya ruzale mumbu. Bamulabia inakweze motoka je, motoka Zabagabezu, Zivam Static House, that way. That makes him People Power DP, People Power DP and NRM. Before we know it, he's going to be wearing purple. Or Gemma. You just never know where this guy will lie, but hey. But I want to have an exclusive with him. Because I think I'm tired of beating about the bush with these different artists when it comes to their political stand, because they are the ones influencing Omuntu Wawansi. That's why they hatched up this whole plan to get entertainers into politics, so they cannot avoid the questions. So I think I want to sit down with Camille and tell him, but blood, which one? Fengaba wagizibo, tugendewa. I need to find out these things. I do. All these entertainers that are on the circuit, we need to have real one-on-ones with them and ask them, so, okay, what is your strategy? Just saying. Guys, why is everybody mad at Big Drill because he just has one dope song? Why? Like, yeah, I know at times Big Drill will get cocky when he's on social, but don't we all? We all get cocky on social media because you don't have to interact with someone face to face. Get that cocky with me in person, you could lose a tooth or two. I might punch you in the face. But if we meet on social media, it's not fair grounds. I've seen people saying weird stuff all because of... Look here, Ugandans. I know it is hard for us to honestly and genuinely appreciate artists. It is hard. We're just naturally pessimistic. But Big Trill gave you a song that you enjoyed. Yes, if he's feeling cocky, let him. That is not a regular thing. It's not every day Cardi B and Offset are dancing to your song. Right? It's not every day that the different people who made that song go viral on social. It's not every day that happens. So why can't you just let the man, you know, have a minute? Mwenamuya Mumutisa, it is just one song. We made you, you made who? Ugandans, you made who? You made who? This boy went and sat down in his studio and did a song that all of you liked. And now that he's trying to get props and, you know, ask you to put some respect on his name, you're finna scare him with something like, we made you, we can break you. You made who? You made who? I need for you Ugandans who come on social media, especially on Twitter, and you feel you have so much to say on so many things to understand, apart from your battery, your data, and your miserable life, you're not making or breaking anybody. It's not going to do jack. If my life is supposed to go a certain way, it will go like that. Mulekera okutisa abantu ku social media. Especially these artists who have not been... Katinga kamide biyote basobola bimugamba, amanyi kamide akuba. Big Trill, maybe you should just start flaunting with your, you know, kuba yongaba satu Big Trill. That is usually how we induct our artists into the Ugandan industry. You have to have a barb fight, and then you have to beat someone really good. I condone violence, but at this point, I think it's the respect you'll get. Street cred. Just say, damn, you guys disgust me at times. Our very own, anyway, why do I care? This is my job, right? And on that note, that is pretty much what happened over the weekend, kinda. Everything was political. It was political, and I can't help it. But anyway, @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's TinaFierce1 with an H. And on Snapchat, we are TinaFierce1. And by the way, for all of you dimwits who come on television and not understand that in TV, there's something called lighting. In TV, there's something called a green screen. In TV, there's something called a camera angle. Editing, binge, yeah? Stop coming to my TL and asking if I have bleached. Bobo ulirango ya gara kumanya nyokala yange ntufu. Zunzo obugulo je ku new visioni ondabi. Ochitegera. True fake asses. Anyway. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop was sponsored by